A few months ago, I appeared on ENCA to express my views on the events surrounding Trump, the insurrection, and how the Republican Party in the United States of America has become the personality cult of Trump. How that personality gave rise to the insurrection that we saw on January the 6th on the Capitol. The events that have unfolded over the past few days here in South Africa has shone a spotlight on our vulnerable society, how political leaders and personalities use the status quo to advance their own agendas and to protect their own selfish interests. What we saw here in the province of KZN and Gauteng was a well-orchestrated attempt by the faction of the ANC aligned to Jacob Zuma, who has been imprisoned for contempt of court. Zuma and his radical economic transformation faction has always been a cult of Zuma within the ANC organization itself. With the radical economic transformation realizing that their Zuma faction was slowly being rooted out and confronted by the Ramaphosa faction, it was time for them to stage a fight back to protect their criminality and own looting of the state coffers for over a decade. Their aim was to destabilize the economy and South Africa as a whole by crippling our supply chain and infrastructure. The names of those responsible are already well known, according to the Minister of Police and the Minister of State Security. A reformed National Prosecuting Authority has put key players like suspended Secretary General Ace Magashule on the defensive, as he now faces Free State-related corruption charges in court in August. The ANC itself has put its own reform into top gear. In the past week, it has suspended Karl Niehaus, Mpumalanga leader Michael Ngwenya, and on Wednesday, they suspended the Eastern Cape renegade politician Andile Lungisa. And as I've said before in a podcast on political cults, history is littered with examples of this. Show people the contradicting statements and utterances of these characters, and cognitive dissonance sets in. Their minds simply short circuits in an attempt to justify and legitimize the contradictions and the flip-flops. Some people will wake up, some won't. There's no doubt that the criminal element took over the chaos which was instigated by the hidden hands under the veil. Many were opportunists going along with the masses and got swept up in the herd mentality. And as this dies down within the next few days and communities pick up the pieces in the aftermath, this will have an effect on people's mental health, people's physical health, and overall well-being. But they will rebuild. Those who instigated this madness should be held accountable. South Africa has a fragile economy and may have survived this past week of violence and mayhem, but only just. It might not be so lucky next time.